Using the InQSight live cell analysis system, users can perform long-term live cell imaging experiments that can last from hours to days in cultures maintained in cell culture media as opposed to a simple buffer solution. Most media formulations contain riboflavin, an essential vitamin and common media component that is excited and emits fluorescence in the same spectral range as GFP. As a consequence, riboflavin can provide a background fluorescence signal in the green channel when imaging cells in cell culture media. For more information regarding the fluorescent contribution of riboflavin in media, please refer to the InQSight background fluorescence technical note that can be found on the InQSight website. Unwanted fluorescent signal can also be due to other factors. For example, cellular autofluorescence, which is known to increase with decreasing metabolic activity due to cell death, particularly in the green channel. Another possible cause of background fluorescence is unbound fluorophores in the media. When cells have dim expression, fluorescence arising higher up in the media than the imaging plane will potentially be overcorrected at the image edges or center. This is due to the method by which the InQSight is calibrated, and images are corrected to ensure relative sensitivity to all objects in the image plane. This can result in the appearance of fluorescent background artifacts, appearing as either a halo or a cross. A halo-type artifact can be seen when imaging with the 4x or 10x objective, whereas a cross can be observed when imaging with the 20x objective. These effects diminish with increasing genuine fluorescent signal within the image. To correct for background fluorescence, the InQSight software offers integrated image processing techniques. One of these is top-hat background subtraction. This technique offers a solution to effectively segment fluorescent objects in images with highly non-uniform backgrounds, as well as eliminating the effect of local background values on object intensity metrics. This segmentation mode is available in the basic analyzer package of the InQSight software. Top-hat background subtraction works by separating fluorescent signals into two compartments: background and genuine signal, and can be explained by the moving disk concept. To determine genuine signal, the user defines a disk based on the radius, in micrometers, of the largest fluorescent object within an image. In the case of non-circular objects, the shortest distance from the center of the object to the background should be chosen. This radius value can be determined by using the measuring tool found within the InQSight software. Once the appropriate radius is determined and entered into the InQSight software, a disk is generated, which moves systematically through the image, comparing each pixel's neighbors within the disk to determine the local background. Once the local fluorescent background levels are determined, these are then subtracted from the original image, resulting in background subtracted image. When defining the radius value, it is better to overestimate by approximately 30%. If the radius chosen is significantly too large, the top-hat algorithm may lose the subtle background gradient changes. If the radius is set too small, partial loss of objects may be observed. Following removal of the fluorescent background, a threshold value, typically a value above the autofluorescence signal of an unlabeled control, is set by the user to properly segment the image. Using top-hat background subtraction allows for the determination of raw fluorescent intensity values for each object within an image without the inclusion of the background components. This allows for comparative analysis between fluorescent objects, generating unambiguous images, and is recommended for segmenting fluorescent images on the InQSight.